So students, how are you doing? Hope you are doing well there at home. Hope that you are keeping safe and observing the measures that ensure that you don't get this disease. So just keep on observing those measures that you're being told by MOH, and then together we shall overcome. So today's lesson, I want us now we move further from what you've been dealing with. Remember, for the time being, we have been dealing with the concept of the theoretical probability. And in terms of the theoretical, the experimental probability. And this experimental probability, we have been saying that it relies with the experiment that is done plus the observation that are going to be corrected. And also again, if not the experiment, then it is also going to rely with the past experience which have been carried out. So as we move on and then we discuss more on another concept, we move from the experimental probability and then now we focus on the theoretical probability, whereby it is the probability that you don't need to perform an experiment, or maybe you don't have to rely on the past experience. What you need to come up is the list of the possible outcome, and then from there you can be able to give the probability of a given event. So as you move on, the objective of today's lesson, I want you as a learner, you should be in a position to be able to carry out, let me put my microphone, you are supposed to be able to determine the theoretical probability given a certain concept. So that's what I'm saying is going to be my objective of today's lesson. But before that, last time I never gave you the assignment, the first assignment, but I want you to be able to focus on it, is on your exercise 8.1, and there you're going to focus on some questions that are involving the experimental probability. Just to remind you what we did. So there we have same page 164 of your course book. We have question 1, 2, and 3, and then I want us to focus on a question number 1. Just remind you what you are supposed to do in the case of the experimental probability. The question is telling us that you have a simple die, that is number 1 now, which I'm referring to on page 164. It's telling us that you have a simple die which is drawn 100 times. So you have a die, drawn up. It is drawn up 100 times. So that is the event, or that is the experiment. This experiment which you say is being done there. What is the experiment? Whereby we have a die, and this die is drawn up 100 times. So that is the experiment. So from this experiment, what are the outcome or the observation? Then we are told, and the number of five appears 14 times. So five appears 14 times. That is the number outcome. That is the first outcome for the five. Then again, you are told, find the experimental probability of drawing a five, giving your answer as a fraction in the lowest terms. So what is the probability of obtaining a five during this event? So you're saying, in the case of the proper experimental, we said it's going to be the favorable number of outcome over the total number of the trials. So in our case, you're going to focus on this. We ask ourselves, how many favorable outcomes are favoring 5? So you're saying, in an experiment whereby you're drawing a fair die 100 times, the ones that are favoring 5, remember a fair die is labeled from number 1 up to 6. A fair die have a 6 side. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the list of all possible outcomes. And out of these 100, outcomes, the one which are favoring a 5 are only how many? Are only 14. So that is the outcome that you're talking about. So if you need to be able to achieve the probability of getting a 5, it's going to be the favorable number of the outcome over the total number of the trials. But again, you're told to give your answer in the simplest form. So you have to make sure that you simplify again. So again, the question is telling you, giving your answer as a fraction in the lowest form. Remember, so that one is going to be 14, which are favoring 5, over the total number of the trial, which is 100. So if you remember the way we said in our last lesson, we said the probability can be expressed in terms of the fraction in terms of the decimal and in terms of the percentage on those 3 weeks. So in our case, we are told that we give the probability in fraction, but in the simplest form. Meaning if you give your answer as this one, you're not going to be awarded, but you have to simplify by eliminating the common factor. So by 2, this one give us 7, then by 2, this one give us 50. So the answer is going to be 7 over 50 is the correct answer. So that's what I want you to be able to do in number 2 and number 3. In your course book there, there's the diagram, and we have part A and part B. And then we are going to meet in our whole classroom if there is any case of the question that require me to elaborate for you. But for the time being, let us now shift our concept from the experimental probability, and then we go to the theoretical probability. So it's going out to be theory. The theoretical probability. The probability. We see what is going to happen in this concept. This is going to be our sub D concept in terms of the theory. So meaning here, you don't perform any experiments, just deal with the list of the possible outcome, and then you give out U or probability. And then we are saying this theoretical probability can be calculated without, so the keyword is what? Without necessarily using any past experience or doing any experiment. So here we don't necessarily perform an experiment or do an experiment. We don't rely on a past experience, or again, we don't do any experiment. Then the probability of an event happening is going to be the favorable number of outcomes over the total number of the outcomes. So here we are not going to talk about the time. So this one is going to be given by the number of the favorable. This one is going to be the total number that are going to favor one of it. It's going to be the total number favorable. Number of favorable outcomes over the total possible. Number of outcomes. So you can see in this case, we are not mentioning the word trial. We're not mentioning the word trial, but here we are talking about the case of the results. Remember, the results are the one that we are calling the outcome. The one that you're calling the outcome. So here we are talking about the outcomes because you're not performing any experiment, neither are we relying on past experience. So the probability of an event happening is given by the number of the favorable outcome over the total possible number of outcomes. Let's try to do some examples, and then we see what is going to happen in that case. So example number one is going to be as follows. So take on it. So in that example, we are told that a basket contains 5 red balls, 5 green balls, and then 3 blue balls. So you're told if a ball is picked at random from the basket, find the probability of picking a blue ball, and then the probability of not picking a red ball. So that's the issue that you're talking about here again. So in this case, we have been given the event which the person is doing. Then you're told here we have a basket, and this basket of viewers, we have the number of what? Basket contain number of the red balls, which are 5. Then again we are told, we have the green balls, green one are 4. And then we have the blue one are 3. So this was contained in the basket. Then you put your hand there. And then, what is going to be the probability of you picking the one which is blue? So you have to come here and then we ask, how many are we having in total? So this one is going to be the total outcomes that you can get, total outcomes. That you can be able to get are how many? The red one are 5, plus the what? The green one are 4, plus the blue one are 3. So this one gives us 5 plus 4, that is 9. Then 9 plus 3, that gives us 12. So we have the possible number of the outcome that you can get are going to be 12. Then we come to which one are favoring the blue one. which one are favoring, which one are favoring the blue one. So you can ask ourselves, in that case you can be able to check how many are going to favor the blue, and then we see the blue one you have, how many are there? This one are 12. Then next is to be able to substitute to the formula the probability of picking the blue ball. The probability of picking the blue ball is going to be the favorable number of the outcome, which is 3, then over the total number of outcome, which is 12. Which we say that in this nature, don't leave your answer. Don't leave your answer in this case or false. Don't leave it in the case of the if it is not in the simplified form, meaning that you have to simplify it. That's what you're going to say by 3, 1, and then by 3. This one is giving us 1. That's how we can be able to get this one, you can be able to get your full marks. So you're trying to identify the concept there. As you can see, we are working here. But you're saying you find the total number of the balls there are 12, then the number of the blue ball are 3. And then in the case of the solution, we are saying you are going to be 3 over 12. And then 3 over 12, I'm saying don't leave your answer if it is not on simplified form. So if it is not on simplified form, you have to make sure that you simplify. So that's what I'm speaking about in that concept. When it comes to part B, we are told that we find the number. In this case, we are told part B that find the probability of not picking a red ball. So what is the probability of not picking a red ball? And that one you're going to see it in our next part of the video.